Pretty much.
You come to New York, though, you got to come to Nebulous. That's the thing. It's like you're in New Jersey, come to Hitbox, New York, Nebulous. Yeah. Do your thing. But I figure I should give some good old shout-outs.
Yep.
And I think we're getting started. Fountain of Dreams. How are the counter picks? Is it only bottom three stages, or is it all six?
I think last semester it was the bottom three, but now it's all six.
It's all six now. Okay, cool. So yeah. We have.
I think so.
So it says 20 stocks apiece. I guess it's 5-on-5.
Yeah.
So we have Counter 3 versus Rye.
Actually, it's going to be 28 stocks.
Oh, it should be 28 stocks? Okay.
Because seven people.
Seven people. All right. So, Kano 3's Falco. Now, I really like watching Kano 3's Falco play. I've seen him play a couple times now. And wow, that forward smash. Now, the thing about TMG that can really get to you is nerves, honestly. Because you have not only your team behind you, you have the other team behind you. Tipper, we have spectators behind you. And it's kind of like, you know, a lot of players that are good players, you know, they're you know, top players, they're accustomed to being on the top, you know, on the stage and people screaming when they do things. But, you know, when you get to TMG, there's players that don't have that kind, they're not used to it, right?
Yeah.
So all of a sudden you got people screaming and you're like, oh, what do I do? I don't want to be a combo video.
What is it? My first TMG, when I was doing the crew battle, my heart was like pacing like,
super
fast.
Your heart races, right? And wow, Kano 3 takes a one stock lead, 53%, nice. You know, pretty doable for Marth. But as you can already see the spacing. He's trying to push himself into Falco a little too hard. He really wants to get something going. And Kano 3 is just playing actually really solid. I like how he's kind of just keeping him out. He's like, you know what? Nah. Okay, that was questionable.
Yeah. Over the past few months, he's got a ton more consistent. He used to SD quite a bit, but now, like.
Now that wall jump in a side B is. Oh, wait, he might. No, he's. Okay, he got it. He got it. That was pretty cool. He didn't get the down air, but he did get the forward smash to close it off. But anyway, you know, the wall jump in the side B on stage is pretty cool. Oh, just barely got out of that. Nice back air. See if he can set up an edge guard. Forward smash. That's going to do it. All right, so. Hostra is the name of this college, Hostra University. Yep. So Hostra is down a stock right now, but I mean, this is pretty big. You know, you got counter pick advantage. This is the most pivotal match. So you got to put somebody that maybe isn't your anchor, but is definitely able to keep under pressure because you need that player like very harsh.
Yeah, that's the reason I put him as the starter for this match because he's been very consistent lately.
I haven't seen you play in a while. Okay, so those wall jump side Bs he needs to be careful with. Just standard recoveries, because that's two stocks right there that he just lost. And Marth has a grab. He can definitely get something going off of this. Nice. He's going to get off of there. Nice wave lamp. He's going to catch an up tilt, another grab. He's starting to even this game right back up.
He's actually getting pretty close.
Now Kano 3 is starting to get a little antsy. Okay.
Oh.
Oh.
Oh my
that
gosh.
Time the wall jump side B worked out.
That was scary.
Okay. So he jumps up at the down air, and he's kind of trying to bait him out on that platform. The forward smash was definitely a flub. Good spot dodge. Now he's trying to... Okay, he got the jab, which was a nice setup. That was death. He just played. Oh, that's it. He pops off. And Kano 3 had a lead, but he has to walk away from that one. Some really rough approach options from Kano 3. But, I mean, that's only one stock.
Yeah.
I mean, you have your counter pick. I know they have counter pick advantage now by one stock, and it is a Marth. So Marth was a pretty solid character to put in first. When you have a lot of momentum characters like Falco, you have to be very careful with how you approach, especially in those situations.
Yeah. Looks like up next we're going to have Binder, our Captain Falcon player.
The Falcon we saw, right? Okay, so we got a Falcon up next. Now, Falcon Marth. A lot of people say Falcon wins. I don't really have an opinion on this because I watch it all the time, but I just don't know. It's one of those matchups you can watch forever and you'll never figure out what you want to believe. For me, that's Marth Falcon. So, obviously these guys juggle each other, these guys combo each other to hell and back, and these guys edgeguard each other. Well, Marth can really get Falcon. You know, those down tilts, he can just edgeguard super easily. So anyway, we have match two. So I think it's 23-24, 24-25? 23-24 should be. 24-25. Yes. Okay.
There we go.
Wow. I don't even know how to math, and that was the first freaking match. So, I just got off a long travel. I'm just glad to be in an air-conditioned environment.
Oh yes.
And just be like here. I'm just so glad. Took me so long. But anyway.
I'm not gonna lie. Nebulous Prime, super nice venue.
Nebulous is amazing, dude. I love Nebulous. I will sit here and I will. Bump up Nebulous for a long time. I love it here. Every time I come here, it's fun. And now we got TMG, which is a great thing. Okay, we got Dreamland. Perfect pick. Marth's got a runoff. What's going on? Hand warmer, maybe? Okay, he's running off.
Yeah,
okay.
He's just practicing a little tech between those
SDs. Like, hey, he might want to run off. He's like, oh, I got you, I got you. So we got one stock on Rai. Actually, it wasn't looking that good. He was down, and then he came back. But now we've got Bayandir. Countdown. 2, 1, go. All right, we're into it. 4 stocks to 1. Let's see what our Captain Falcon player can do here. Now, this is also a tense situation because you do not want to die.
Yeah, because then you get the stock lead.
If they take a stock, he's revered as a hero, correct? So it's like, all right, I can't let this happen. Whoa, there's the Raptor Goose. Goes for the knee a little too far for it. Now, there's the shield grab. Nice mash. Gets right out of it. And that could have... Nice knee. Waits for that down air and just punishes him with that knee. Very good stuff. And now, that was a quick match. 50, what was that? Like, it was like 20 seconds.
Yeah.
That's sometimes all it takes for one stock to four. All right, so
Hunter's
he...
super consistent player.
Yeah.
Super good at approaching and...
I'm going to have a strong talking to KN03 after this crew battle.
Yeah?
I'm going to sit with him. I'm going to teach him to deal with lasers. Because he didn't use the gun enough.
Yeah.
He's got to use the gun. So I'm going to sit there with him, and I'm just going to play Puff and be like, shoot me. I like that guy, though. Anyway, so luckily to your Captain Falcon player here, you guys are at an even match, but the problem is they have the counter pick advantage. Now they have a Captain Falcon sitting right here. He's sitting there. He's bumping around. And I got a Captain Falcon. He's sitting right here. He's got pretty good tech. But yeah, you know, what do you do to answer this? And we have someone sitting down right now. I think I recognize this guy. I think I played against him in doubles. He might be the Ice Climbers player.
If he is, then I'm going to be going in next.
No, he's the Falco. Okay, his teammate I played him in teams. His teammate was the Icy's player. He's the Falco.
Do you know which one that was and how good was he?
I was getting wobbled. That's all I know.
Oof.
I got wobbled. And I was like, and it was doubles, luckily. So like my other teammate got me out. So I was like, all right.
Yeah.
But so we have another Falco. We have a Falco coming in from the other side. So far we've seen Falco Falcon and Marth Falco. We're going straight to FD. So is there a stage ban?
Is there?
Because this is a great counter pick, I have to say.
I'm not actually too sure. I haven't read up on the most recent rules. I remember what they were. Well, they were the bottom three last time.
I think he just gets
a straight up pick what he wants.
It was bottom three zero bans. Now I think if they expand it to six, it might be one ban. But I don't know. Anyway, I'm going to look up on that. I'm going to look into that. So we have FD. So FD kind of seems like what Falco would counterpick a Falcon to.
Yeah.
Or Fountain, maybe. So there could have been a ban. But anyway, we have Falco up against Captain Falcon. Now, a lot of Falcon means do complain about the Falco. Falco does win this matchup. But, you know, the question is how much. You know, his lasers kind of lock down Captain Falcon because those projectiles are just so, they have hit stun. You know, they're so hard to get by. So we're going in with a 4-stock match, so no countdowns. So this is just a straight-up match, see what we can do here. And so far, this Falco player, Zeus. Oh, right, Zeus was his tech. He's definitely proving to me, you know, and there's the first stock of that back air.
Wow, 19%.
He's definitely proving to me how this matchup should be looking. Now, that means he's playing it very solidly. You know, he's playing very methodical. He's kind of staying away, giving Falcon, you know, spacing him out. Getting his own space, because, you know, you have FD. There's a lot of room to run around. No platforms, and Falcon can kind of just... if he gets a stomp and tries to capitalize off it just like that, there's the Nair, but it doesn't get anything else off of it.
Yeah. Throwing out on Nair a little too much for approaching.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
I think if the Falco can get past his Nair approach, then he's pretty much set for this match. Because that's what Mindo relies on quite a bit.
Oh, that dash attack. Sends him a little far away, but it's not going to, you know, take the stock. Now, I would be... All right, so he opts for the F tilt instead of the up tilt. Really, just no matter what, Falco covered that really well. But that is going to be an up throw into up there. Now he has his jump. That's going to do it. Oh no, he didn't roll.
Ooh.
Oh, he SD'd. He SD'd. All right, the Falcon. He starts dancing. He's like, yes, thank God, dude. All right, so no jump. Oh, that forward smash. That laser took the double jump, and he double jumped just right over the ledge, which is not the best idea. You want to just try to recover low. And if Falco goes for that downer, you want to try and tech it. Okay, down throw. Captain Falcon. Come on, we need a Captain Falcon stock. Come on. Can you give me a Johnny stock? Oh, man, that shield pressure is so real. Two up tilts.
He's got to get out of there.
He is just letting... Now the thing is, Zeus is starting to say, hey, now he's kind of not... He doesn't appreciate when I'm taking space. Now I'm going to start pressuring him. Now I have the lead. Up throw.
Ooh, that's
no, good tech. Good tech. Ah, now that was a good idea. Wavelands back onto the stage. You know, he has these setups that make sense, but he's not executing, and he's a little... Oh, that read. He's fine, though. He's fine. Yeah. Nice tech away. All right, down throw. So what you... Oh, okay. So he's down three stocks to one. Zeus is playing really well. Oh. Again. And that's the SD.
No.
So that is a total of two stocks taken from, I believe, Bandir was his tech. Zeus played that matchup like it was his job. I really enjoyed how he played that.
All right, up next we have, from my school, we have Mike, also known as Rez, playing probably, playing Peach.
Aw, I was waiting for a Puff, dude.
No, I'm sorry, we don't have any Puff players.
I would just start coaching him from here. Yo, shield grab him! Up the rest! Get him! But we got Peach. All right, this is even more interesting. So we got Peach Falco. Whether you think this is a good counter pick, what other, you know, characters do you have in your lineup? No, don't say it out loud, because they have some guy right there listening.
What is it? I think it's actually pretty good. What is it? I know Mike and Kano.
You should be fine.
Oh, yeah, you guys are all good. I know Mike versus Kano 3. Mike usually, like, does... He has a lot of practice against Falco and does pretty well against him, so...
All right, so I'm Falco does have to SD only once. He had three whole stocks on that, so 23 to 20.
This is going to be tough.
So, you know, 20 stocks still remain. Five players left on this Steven side. So, you know, this is honestly so doable. And all it takes is this Peach. And now, right now, Peach is still yet to get the first hit onto Zeus. And Rez trying to find an opening, but Zeus, oh, tries to get that grab. Nice F tilt into the laser forward smash. Zero to death starting that first stock. Zeus playing so well. And, you know, you can tell right now, Zeus has a really patient Falco. And I like how he's just kind of taking his space and he's just using it to his advantage. And he's gone to FD again. So FD being a re-counter pick, interesting. You know, we already saw that Zeus was comfortable on this stage. So maybe a counter pick from whoever made this counter pick stage, I guess Rez. Maybe Dreamland, maybe a... no, huh? I don't know. It would come to preference, but I would see that FD and be like, no. So three stocks even. Rez is trying to find a way in. Nice nair. Okay, get off me. Dash tech. Nice down smash. He says get him off. All right, there's the shine. Tries to get that up air. See if he can finish it off the top, but he's getting a little antsy there. Eats that down smash. Not the best thing you could do. And the stock is gone. Rez taking a stock. So Zeus eating a down smash to start the stock off. A nice 22% for Rez. And just standing in place, shield grabbing, you got to stay more mobile.
Yeah.
Especially with the Falco. That can kind of just lock you down in one place and then punish you when you're in that one place. And, oh, nice.
Here we
go. Oh, he almost got that. But, oh, the down smash nicks him. There's
there
the nair.
Go.
Nice nair, and that should do it.
Yep.
Nice, and he takes the stock and taunts. Good stuff by Rez. Played that really methodically, and I really slow.
Oh, yeah, his edge guarding is on point.
His edge guarding was just like, all right, I'm going to throw this, then I'm going to do this. And it just all worked out, you know? Nice. Eats another down smash. So, you know, Zeus was looking really solid at first, but now a nice back air as shield.
Yeah.
All right, so Zeus.
Stock ahead.
How many stocks has Zeus taken?
He's taken...
That was dirty.
He's taken six, if I'm correct.
He took...
Because he took all four stocks off of Binder.
Well, who did he beat for... Oh, no, yeah, he took all four and then two from Rez. Yeah.
So
he's
so
on
far,
six right now. But if he takes one more... Okay. Oh, that forward air is actually really well placed. All right, nice sweet spot. Gets on there. Another down air. Oh, and he eats a down smash, but he's okay. Nice sweet spot yet again. Trying to space him out with a neutral air. Dash attack on shield. No punish, though. Rolls behind him twice. There's a neutral air. Is he going to get this edge guard? He runs off, and it kills.
Oh, no.
The up B kills off of the top. Don't even know how that's possible. Barely does it. And now Rez is down to his last stock. Is he? Oh, and he catches the turnip. Imagine if that was a stitch. I would have freaked out. All right, that should do it.
All right.
And Rez is the man to put the nail in Zeus's last stock. And right now we have a 3-stock lead for not your team.
Yeah.
Oof. So,
what is it? I'm assuming they're not going to.
Who's your anchor?
Our anchor is Adam.
MPK. I haven't seen you in so long, dude. What's up? Huh? Well, that's what we're watching. Oh, you're playing? Brad, all right, I'll commentate it.
You know anything about this, Captain Falcon?
What is this tag? I've never seen it before.
Beats me.
Okay, so Captain Falcon versus Peach. Interesting. Mac Daddy. So Rez is down one stock, so 1720. Oh, it should be, 1720. Yep, that's right. Okay, so we have... Yoshi's Story, so this is a pretty good Falcon counter pick. Kills very early, so we're going to go straight into an instant knee. Goes right in with
gosh.
It. Beautiful. You know, sometimes that's what you got to do, just run in with that full hop knee. And nice. Getting right on his shield. This Falcon looks really solid. Okay, good dash. We got a tennis racket. Golf club. So Rez trying to get this first stock. If he gets this first stock, it'll be great for Stevens. Okay, gets a forward throw.
We're alive, though. We're living.
That was actually pretty interesting DI, but it managed to keep him alive. F tilted, but he's going to treat with the backer. I could very much tell that Rez is nervous right now.
Yeah.
But he's doing the best with what he can.
You gotta
appreciate that he's at least, you know, doing a pretty solid job. Nice punish in there. Oh, we got a tech chase opportunity, but he's gonna get out of the stomp situation. That was almost a,
Oh, tennis racket again.
Bop. Oh, baby. Nice. Oh, and that border is gonna do it. There's a stock. All right. So what can Rez do?
There we go.
I was about to say, what can Rez do with this high percent stock? But
still 3 stocks up.
You know, he did his job. He had to take that one more stock, because if Rez lost that stock right there, that would have been a 4-stock deficit.
Hold on. Give me 1 second.
Consult with your team. Go right ahead. Oh, man. We're here at the Melee Games. This is some good stuff. Pretty hot matches. I finished my water bottle. Let's go. All right. So we have a gentleman in glasses sitting down with a Steven shirt, and he's a Falco player.
Same shirt.
So this is the counter pick that happened to the year Falcon.
Yeah.
Someone went Falco on him, right? So
hope he goes to FD.
We're in Tri-State, dude. You gotta go to Battlefield. You gotta go to Battlefield.
Fun fact, this is one of our new players. He's a freshman. What is his tag?
It's XLNC.
Yeah, XLNC.
Extra large North Carolina.
Who knows? Maybe. I have to ask him about that one of these days. What is it?
Go on.
I haven't really seen that much of him. The first time I actually played him was like today. We had a little tournament over at Stevens, and he just like ended up being really good. Apparently, I wasn't there for that, so all the other players told me to add him. So he's pretty good, though. He's super good at adapting. I'll have to say that much.
Yeah. So we saw that first stock go down. If you say he's very good at adapting, then we're gonna have to see. We're definitely gonna see something happen here. You know, some sort of change in his playstyle. Definitely understands now what's going on with this Captain Falcon, and standing gangster laser does not care. All right, let's see who's going to get here. Oh, shoots him, and he's just going to, you know,
go down the buses.
If it works, it works. Yeah, we take those, man. All right, so now 3 stocks to 2, 18 of 15. So right now you guys are kind of trading in the situation you're in, which is that 3-stock deficit.
Yeah.
So instead of trading, you got to start putting in that work, and you're going to need that kind of player that could definitely just start putting it in, and hopefully XLNC is that guy for you. Nice, up tilt in the back air. Oh, and this stomp goes through that platform somehow through the gods. Oh, the first hit of that Phantom was a Nair. I mean, the first hit of that Nair is a Phantom. F smash.
There we go.
Wait, he's alive. Falcon. Shot out of the Falcon kick.
Sniper.
That was pretty nice. Now, you saw he lost that one stock. He took two back to back. So, you know, you said he's pretty good at adapting. You were definitely right. And he almost ate that knee right there. And So right now, Mac Daddy, ooh, comes in with that knee. Every single kill he's gotten, just boom, just fly through with that knee. All right, so XLNT taking a deep breath. Nice.
There we go.
Wow, that down tilt was a great idea. And he's dead. Zero to death.
And I believe we're only two stocks behind?
You are now only two stocks behind. That is definitely what you guys needed.
Yes.
You guys need to start pushing through like that. That Falco was super clean. You said he's good at adapting. Three.
Yep.
Boom, boom, boom. Well, he died. But, you know, he took three right there. He did what he had to do. So, all right, we nap. What does that mean?
I don't know. It's his tag. He put it as a sponsor tag in Smash.gg, so.
Okay. So, we have a Marth. We got Marth Falco. It comes down to the Marth player where he wants to go, really.
Yeah.
You know,
I'd be surprised if he wants to go to FD, though.
I would be, too. Some people argue that it's, like, closer to even on FD because of lasers.
Oh, yeah, also chain grabs from Marth.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah.
You know, the zero to death is still there. We're going to go to FD, though. So, I believe XLNC has two stocks. So, 14 to 16, the deficit doesn't look so bad. I mean, two stocks? You got a combo machine over here.
Yeah.
So, let's make it work. Man, that countdown was so good.
Yeah.
And already we have 25%. Oze.
Ooh. Damn.
Hits him with that forward smash. Oh, he gets burned, but that's all right. He's back up into neutral. Okay. Whoa! That was dash tag and a... Oh, he's living. Weak back air. Gets right on top of him with the shield poke downer. Oh, he runs straight in on that. Get up attack. Down smash comes out. Up air and a forward smash. Wow, that was the weirdest combination of moves. He threw a down smash in there. Oh no. He's living.
Okay.
No jump. Down tilt. He's alive. Forward smash. Oh man. That game was almost over. You almost saw him get up, shake his hand. But guess what? We're still in it. Oh, the power shield. Yeah, Falco needs to find something. Up throw and a forward smash, the mix-up. You guys are back down to three stocks.
I might be going in now. I gotta check. Hold on.
So three players remain on the Stevens crew. One of them sitting right next to me.
All right. I'm pulling my anchor in, by the way.
Your what?
He's our anchor. He's his name is Adam.
You're calling him in now?
Yeah, I'm calling him in now. Right before we entered here, he's saying, I feel super, super confident about the Marth matchup right now.
And the Marth Ditto?
Yeah, the Marth Ditto.
Oh,
yeah.
I love me some Marth Dittos.
Yes, yes.
That's my favorite matchup. Marth Dittos. Let's watch some Marth Dittos.
If there's one thing that Adam is super good at, it is reads. He reads like a madman.
Yeah, it's your counter pick.
All right.
This is exactly what I would do. All right, so we're going to Battlefield now. We have three stocks or two stocks?
Three
stocks.
Yeah.
Okay, so here comes the countdown. All right, so we're going into it. Marth Dittos. Now, the thing about Marth Dittos is the first grab matters so much. You have to play that neutral like it's your heart and soul. Now, instantly, you know, oh my God. And that's Marth Dittos, man. That's Marth Dittos.
One grab and you're done for, just like you said.
One grab and your stock can just disappear. You got the forward throw chains into the juggling. And as you see right here, Oze, nice counter. All right, so now Paradigm, is that his tech?
Paradigm.
Paradigm.
Yeah, Paradigm.
So Paradigm, oh, he's dead. All
there
right.
There we go.
So Paradigm has to put in some serious work if he wants his crew to succeed. And 11 stocks to 14, he definitely has to start putting in some work. Nice. Oh! These guys are playing some hella neutral right now, but guess what? I don't think there's a jump. There's a jump now. He uses it up. Now Marth can just juggle himself, dude. That waveline was super crisp, and he's gotta get a grab. Nice down tilt. Ooh, runs over that forward smash, still gets the roll punish. Forward throw and a forward throw. Oh, nice. Okay. Nice grab. And he's playing it really well. When you're playing on the offensive, you have to take those stocks because up tilt's gonna do it.
Yeah.
Paradigm has lost two stocks, whereas Oze has only lost one. That one's going to do it, though, if he gets this ledge hog. No jump. That's going to do it.
There we go. And down to one stock. If he can take it, I think we can bring this back.
He can take this game without dying again. Forward throw and an up throw. Jump is gone. Up tilt. Tech's on the platform. He's back on the ground. But saying that the jump is gone in this match is so important to point out, because that is the point where you are actually at kill percent.
Yeah.
Even if you're at zero and your double jump's gone, you're at kill percent. One tipper, no jump. Oh, he somehow miraculously off the text that. Oh, just charged before a smash. Wave that shot of shield, grab. Side B's downwards. Very interesting. Oh, gets shield grabbed out of the side B. That ain't Ken. There's the spot dodge. Nice
Both
nair.
Both these mods go for a lot of forward smashes at low percent.
Because he hit the stage like that, that actually kind of set him up.
Yeah.
All right, so Oze has one stock that he needs to take here in this. Marked it, a 3-4 throws into a forward smash. He's got to be careful. All right, Paradigm.
See if he gets the edge guard.
That's going to do it. Paradigm taking the game. Now, he lost three stocks, and if you think about it, Oze, only, you know, they traded with your anchor. So trading with an anchor is so important, because that kind of spells trouble.
Yeah.
So, you know, we have a lot going on here. We have, I believe it is now 12 to 9.
He has one stock, and then we have two sets of four. So, yeah, that's nine.
And they got three fresh players.
Yeah.
And we have someone sitting down right now.
Let's see who this is.
It is 12 to 9.
Oh, let's see what characters he pull out.
Game
& Watch. We have a Game & Watch player in here.
We have a Game & Watch. Okay. Let's go. He hasn't landed a wavelength yet. Okay.
See, the advantage of playing these really low-tier characters is people don't get to play them that often, so.
You know how important low-tiers are in crew battles? Yeah. Some people just don't have match knowledge. All right, so he's got to play a Mr. Game & Watch, one of the lightest characters in the game, if not the lightest. And we have, so he's actually very easy to kill with a Marth Tipper, and that's going to do it. And the first stock is gone. Now, Marth Tippers on a light character like Game & Watch spells disaster. Zero to death. We got an up tilt, goes for the down tilt. Nice jab setup into the grab. Into a forward air. What are we going to see here? Oh,
he wants
if he got the 9, that would have worked. Oh, gets him with the forward smash.
Does 9 have a bigger hitbox?
Yeah. Oh, dash attack. Oh, the counter gets eaten with a down smash. Are we going to see the kill? Nice. Oh. Almost gets the tipper. All right, we got a grab. This might just lead to a nair, and that nair's going to do it.
Yeah, that will.
That was a sick Game & Watch move. So,
yeah, looks like I'm going to be the anchor.
He's actually going to take out. He still has three. That was a nice zero to death, but Game & Watch is a weird character. That was a nice zero to death. You just tippered him. He's like the lightest character. He just dies.
Yeah, up next we have.
Looks like you're the last player.
I guess I am. I really want to play the Ice Commerce player.
I don't know if he's from this crew.
Yeah, he is. The Hofstra has one Ice Commerce player. I saw it on the roster.
That means we're waiting for him.
Yeah.
He might just come out. He might be their anchor. All right, so we have Sheik. We have a Sheik?
Yes.
Well, I would not hesitate. So you're a Luigi and Ice Climbers player.
Yep.
And he is a Sheik player. So you're like, oh, wait, I have a Game & Watch here. I need to throw out the Sheik. So Sheik, Game & Watch, three stocks on the Game & Watch. I've actually seen Game & Watches overcome this matchup, no problem. I've seen it happen. But
I haven't seen this matchup very often, so I can't say
I don't want to jump
same,
to conclusions. I mean, we have Curb. We get to watch Curb Swedish, like, all the time. All right, so Placid is his tag, and Any is his tag. Okay. We got the countdown on lock. You can hear it through my headset, probably. All right, so instantly starting off with the needles. Nice forward air. He's going to play the stage, dude. He has 11 stocks to cheese out. Oh. This is the Game & Watch that wants the 9, dude. He's that kind of Game & Watch. Someone said your projectile is better than his. Come on. Oh, man, that downer led to the down throw. There's the grab.
There might have worked there.
It might have. There's a dash attack. We need a grab here. Or that forward air going to set him up. He's dead.
You have to be careful about that. Game Watch up B has tons of verticality.
It doesn't look like it's going to work,
but
it always works. Oh, he had a chain grab situation, but he actually back through on accident. And that shield poke with a downer into the nair, that might set him up. He's alive. And the forward smash. Good stuff. Sheik has a lot of frames of end lag when she up-bees onto the stage. Enough time for a rest, for really anything. Now, Game Watch forward smash, I guess, counts. Oh, we got a down throw forward air, I think, because they're all the same throw animation. Oh, another throw. Oh, man, and that's a stock.
Yeah, that's it.
Two stocks even.
So they still have two more players behind this, right?
Yes, they still have two more players behind this, and oh my god. Placid's going in right now. Nice down throw. All right, he's gonna sheik him. But the platform does end. Oh, dude, he wants it.
He just waits for it.
We got chained into down tilt from Game & Watch. Dude, I don't even know what's going on.
And you know the one time the nine comes out, it's gonna be the one that hits too. This is how it works.
The people are gonna love it. Oh, that nair might actually seal the deal.
Yep.
Grabs the ledge, that's gonna do it. He DIs, he's alive, but is it gonna happen? Oh, it happens!
Yeah.
Game & Watch survives, but the down smash is gonna take it. One stock apiece, and he had five stocks to nine stocks on Placid. Now, okay, there's the down throw, and he really needs a chain grab here. Oh, but he's gonna get the jab into down tilt, goes for that five. Gets an eight there, he's trying to get that nine. Oh, nice, and Sheik is gonna start getting that grab game going on. There's the chain off stage. He's doing it. Forward air. Can he take the game though? The up B is gonna burn him off of Sheik recovering on stage. This is so even right now. Oh, and the Game & Watch up smash. And the nair's gonna.
Nope.
He puts on the dress. We got a low tier battle now. Oh no. What's happening? We got a low tier battle. Okay.
Smart move.
He's alive. He's very well alive. And he got
there
the flare.
Gotta be careful about that down up
either. And he's dead.
There we go. I'm pretty
wow,
happy.
Wow, that was so clutch.
I don't have to play the Game & Watch because it's weird enough. The Ice Climbers Game & Watch matchup is oddly like even.
That was so cool. That he put on the dress, dude.
Yeah.
All right, so we got five stocks to eight. That three stock deficit has just been holding ever since Zeus put you guys there, really.
Yeah.
And you guys are just trading at this point. But you're going to have to put in some work, dude.
Yes, I will.
No pressure.
All right. So it's eight stocks to five stocks, right?
Eight to five.
All right.
Whatever you've got plus one Sheik stock. Oh, okay.
Yes.
We found him. Oh. Wait.
Oh, wait. No.
You have to go Sheik. Yeah.
You have to go Sheik.
That sucks, though. I would have wanted to go Fox 2 in this because Sheik loses mad hard to Ice Climbers. Popo alone has the chain grab on Sheik. So, you know, this is going to be a rough matchup. Sheik has some options to split up Ice Climbers, but there's not a lot. I watch Zofria play Fry Cook like every week. So, trust me. I understand this matchup.
J-Fox has lately been pulling out on Sheik against Ice Climbers.
Yeah, he's starting to do it again. He has the Peach cop out for FD. But I think he might use Peach for other things too. I don't know. He's still in the midst of like an Ice Climbers crisis, but he's starting to get out of it. He's beaten Frycook the past couple times they played. Alright, so.
3, 2, 1, go!
Alright, so what you need to see here is not a wobble. So, you know, these Ice Climbers are so good in these situations. His tag is Triffle, right, okay. So Ice Climbers are so good in these situations because like you're already nervous as the melee games. And then there's a character that can kill you off of a grab. And it's like they capitalize so hard and they come back always. And that's the wobble. And that is a wobble.
And it's a wobble.
And that is a wobble.
Yes it is.
And that's the stock.
Alright.
Good luck, buddy.
Wish me luck.
You have my blessing, Invis.
All right.
Get in, man. Someone get in. Anybody, I don't care. Zeus, right?
Hello, this is Zeus signing off.
You're the reason they've been at this three-stock deficit this entire crew battle. How does that make you feel?
Feels good. I'm doing my job
you
as a captain, I guess.
You played so well. And then I was watching you just zone them out. And then now they've been trading stocks with your crew, which is exactly what your plan is. It's exactly what you want. You want to keep this lead that you've had this whole time. You put the lead in yourself. You're like, all right, I'm going to work with my hands, give you guys a lead, and then you guys just keep it going.
I got you.
And that's basically what's happening.
Yeah, yeah. Big part of it, we got a lot of favorable matchups. Like, I got to go in against the Falcon.
Yeah.
We have Ice Climbers versus the Sheik to clean that up.
But I have something to tell you right now. Invis is an Ice Climbers player, and we have an Ice Climbers ditto.
That is interesting. So
now he also plays Luigi, but he has to lock in right now. And I think he locked in as Ice Climbers. So I don't know about Invis's skill. I haven't played him in a long time. Mm-hmm. He apparently Paradigm was their anchor, which is the Marth player.
Yeah.
The White Marth. So apparently he was the anchor, but he got Marth dittoed. Marth dittos are so harsh.
Interesting.
But anyway, apparently he's not the best player on the crew, but he's definitely someone to think about. So we're going to FD. All right, so we got Ice Climbers ditto, four stocks even. They're going in right in, no countdown.
Exactly.
And all of a sudden, so Invis is the blue Ice Climbers, and Triffle is playing red. So this is like, the thing about this matchup, I love Ice Climbers ditto, because I think they're hilarious.
They're so messy in a sense that
it's doubles.
Exactly, you're playing doubles.
So pretty much, desyncs. Okay, nice. So
let's go.
Pretty much the goal is to separate. That's what you want.
Oh my gosh.
Nana, get in there!
Oh, what's she gonna do? Oh, he dropped
he got
it!
Out.
Oh my god. Alright, it's okay. As long as you get these good hitboxes out, he's gonna
Alright, Nana's still alive. So this is so doable. Nana's dead.
Oh, the taunt. Alright, so looking for this edge guard right now.
Alright, so Invis gets Triple. Nana off. Nice back airs. We got a Sopo battle.
Tim is looking pretty comfortable with these wave dashes, so hopefully he can finish off.
Oh, he gets them.
But he definitely gets the best of that scenario with the back air.
Nice back air. All right.
Solid edge guard.
So Triffle is going to take Invis' first stock. He has three stocks to take a whopping eight stocks from the entire Hofstra crew. I don't think it's going to be possible, but, you know, we got Ice Climbers. I don't know if he can wobble, but if he can, this would be the time to do it eight times.
Exactly, if he can. I know Triffle actually talked to me about the Ice Climbers matchup, and it's something he feels like he never gets to practice because he doesn't have the people to work with. So I guess the first time experience in a crew battle is working it.
All right, Invis takes his first stock. So the thing is, like, a lot of wave dash down smashes. You're trying to separate Popo and Nana.
Oh my god,
Nana's dead. And Popo, you know, Triffle's still at zero.
Yeah, Triffle playing the stock nicely. And as you said, a lot of like wave dashes and looking
gets
for those
out of
down
the
smashes.
Ooh. Oh! He back threw Nana. I mean, Popo to hit Nana.
Yeah, that was genius.
Trouble.
Oh my gosh. Having trouble like calling up with like which one's which.
So Invis was excited to play the Ice Climbers ditto. He actually likes doing it.
Yeah.
And there's the down smash. So now Invis in a situation where, he's going to drop the stock there.
Exactly. Him knowing he knows that he can't grab the edge after the side B into the stage. So hopefully Tim can...
All right, fully charged a forward smash. Okay.
Doesn't get the separation he wanted, but...
All right, he's just hacking at him.
Exactly. This hitbox is going out.
So, you know, he didn't get that instant kill on Popo, but he did kill Nana, and he does have Popo in a pretty interesting position.
Very true.
No jump. Oh, no, he has a jump. I'm sorry. I lied.
Oh, with a little taunt.
Oh, wow, he made it. Shouldn't have taunted. Oh, Nana, come back.
All right, so
we got two straight stocks, but Nana is at high percent.
All right, I feel like Tim just has to kind of work on, like, not keeping himself so distinct.
I really like how Invis is back throwing Popo.
I do like that. It's very interesting. Because as long as you get them separated, then you can just get to the
Nana's okay.
A lot of charge forward smashes these games, too.
Oh! All right, sacrifice Nana for your stock, and there's the wobble punish.
There you go.
This is what you need.
Exactly.
You need a wobbling Ice Climbers in the melee game.
Very true. Helps to take a lot of stocks. And Tim can finish these off, which is what we need. All right. So
six stocks to one.
Stevens.
This is Stevens' last stock. Nana might be going down now.
Triffle just pounding away.
Who's your last player, by the way?
Our last player would have been our Jigglypuff player. His name is Monsters is his tag.
Oh, I wanted to see a Puff, man.
That'd have been interesting, yeah.
I'm a Puff mate. Oh, he's got the double grab.
That was crazy.
Beat him up. All right. All right. It's not over for Invis yet.
Oh, doesn't get any wave dash there, though. I'm going to be curious how Tim tries to split them up.
All right, he's desyncing with the ice.
Yeah, it looks like nothing on the ground. Oh, little tech flub, but ends up getting.
Oh, wow.
Hit. Oh.
Oh, I wish he got that down smash. That would have been so good. So if this Sopo can take out Nana, wait a minute. Is this Sopo going to do it?
Oh, my God.
Oh, the Nana. Grabbed. The Nana saves him from the edge guard.
Choosing the grab back throws.
Is he going to make it? That's the ledge hog. Right, and that's the entire match. A six stock.
And, yeah, it was good matches, Stevens. They played well.